Uma Girish, can you please switch on your audio, video? Gauri MS and Chandrika Srinivas, switch on the video, please. Okay. I hope all of you have gone through the videos. Any questions are there? Prashnigal enadu idava?
Prabhuji, I have one question.
Very good. Ask.
Prabhuji, you told like we should not tell like I did the coffee. You should tell coffee is done.
Huh.
So, for example, somebody asks who did this coffee, we tell I did that. It's also like ego, no?
No, no. See, to telling communication purpose, you can tell I did the coffee, right?
Yeah.
But you should know who did the coffee. Who did the coffee?
The knowing principle.
Actually, the totality.
Yeah, Brahman.
Yeah, Ishwara. We call as Ishwara, right? The coffee cannot be done without sun. Coffee cannot be done without the nature, right? The totality is what is participating in making a coffee, correct?
Yeah.
So really, who does? God.
Okay.
Right? But we cannot tell everybody that God does. No, they won't understand.
Okay.
They'll get confused. You can tell I did it, but actually you should know inside who really does everything.
Okay.
Are you clear?
Yes. Prabhuji, then why does ego cause suffering? Does it hate our body and all?
Okay. Why does the ego cause suffering? I'll tell you right now. Okay?
Okay.
So... okay, the question is, why does the ego cause suffering? Anybody has answer?
Guruji, I feel that the ego is our own imagination. So what does it exist? When there is an identification, there is a suffering. So it is imagination altogether.
Okay.
So, we involve in karma.
What?
We involve in karma. What? We have ego.
Correct. Yeah, no, ego, ego, why, first let us understand why ego is required, right?
No need.
It is required. It is required.
Right.
Okay, so you seen the coconut? The coconut with the, when you take the coconut from the tree, how the coconut will be?
Full.
It'll have a green shell, right?
Yes.
It a husk is there, correct?
Yes.
That is called coconut, correct? And you remove the husk, then what is there? A shell. That's also called coconut. Then you break it, then white kernel is there. That's also called coconut. Which is real coconut?
No
way. Ah, that husk, white kernel is real coconut. Correct? But with the shell also you call coconut, and with the husk also you call coconut. They are covers, they are packaging, right? So, why the coconut should have husk and shell covering when the real coconut is white kernel? Namit, is the question clear to you? Namit, are you there?
For protection.
So, till what point of time protection is required? The kernel, when the coconut becomes a tree, the husk will break, the shell will break. You understand? So, when the Pratibharao, can you please mute your video audio and come on video. Chandrika also, you should come on video. Okay. So, the husk, it is required as a protective mechanism. Correct? But the protective mechanism has to break. When it has to break? When the coconut has to become tree, it has to break. Correct? So similarly, ego is given to us as a protective mechanism. the child is very innocent, okay, and that it is like a soft kernel, it has to grow. So that's why the hard kernel, hard shell is given. The hard shell is the ego. But when you become jnana, when you get atma jnana, the ego has to break. But till you get atma jnana, you have to become mature. How do you become mature? With the struggles in life, I want to become successful, all those maturity has to happen. So that till that point of ego is required, after that ego is not required. Is the answer clear? Where is Namit? Namit disappeared. Is the answer clear to all?
Yes, Guruji.
Right?
Yes, Guruji. Very clear.
Okay. Vaishnavi?
Yes, Guruji. It is clear.
Ego, if it right from childhood ego is not there, then the child will die.
Oh.
You understand?
Okay.
Did Namit get the answer?
Prabhuji, by mistakely of internet problem, I was not able to stay.
Okay. I'll repeat what I told to others, right?
Yeah.
The coconut gets a shell, coconut gets a husk, and then there is a shell, right?
Yeah.
And there is inside the kernel is the white kernel, correct?
Yeah.
The husk and the shell is protecting the coconut, correct?
Yeah.
Now, till what point of time protection is required?
Maybe till it's plucked from the tree.
No.
Or it's cooked.
No. Till the coconut really becomes, wants to become a tree, then the shell will break naturally. You understand? The coconut, when it goes carried away and it falls into ground and the coconut starts becoming a tree, then the shell will break.
Yeah.
Right? Till that point of time, the protection is required for the coconut, the inside real kernel, white kernel, correct?
Yeah.
Similarly, for us, the ego is a protection till we grow up.
Okay.
You got it? The child is very innocent. If it has no ego, people can hurt it.
Yeah.
So, ego is required to protect yourself till you grow up to become enlightened.
Okay.
Are we getting what I'm saying?
Okay. Means we should treat the ego like a servant.
Ego is like a servant. Ego is like a protection mechanism. Ego is not you what you are.
Is ego the part of the mind?
Ego is the mind.
Okay.
Right? So, but then people don't know that and they think that they are the ego. That's a problem.
Okay.
Ego is like a protection mechanism. It's okay.
But people know what's the meaning of ego. Then why do they say I'm the ego?
That's because they don't really know.
They're not enlightened.
They're not enlightened. They don't understand. They're not gone to guru. They have not got the teaching.
Yeah.
Right?
That's like enlightenment as a special thing.
Correct. That's right.
It's like a spiritual sadhana.
Yes. See, ego should be used, but ego should not use us.
Yeah, true.
Do you understand? But most of the
people, it's a servant, so we should command it.
We should mandate, right? But most of the people they don't know it's a servant, they become the ego.
Yeah.
So that's why, have you seen the serpent in the neck of Shiva?
Yeah, Subramanya.
No. Subramanya. And there is a serpent in the neck of Shiva. There is a serpent, right?
Yeah.
Serpent is a ego. It represents ego.
Okay.
Okay, for...
But Subramanya is like a god, no? Why is it ego?
No. That's a different... That Subramanya is a different thing. I'll tell Subramanya about Subramanya some other time.
Okay.
So this serpent represents the ego. Okay. ego is very poisonous for ordinary people.
Okay.
But for Shiva, it's an ornament. It's a necklace.
Yeah.
You got it? For a jnani, enlightened one, ego is like a necklace. He can use it whenever he want. And he can keep it aside.
Yeah.
Are we clear?
Yeah.
So now, any more questions?
No, but Prabhuji, one more question.
Yes.
Prabhuji, you told consciousness creates thoughts. So consciousness, does consciousness only solve that those thoughts?
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. The knowing principle, Sakshi, only knows, no? It's only correct. It's only solves, helps the solves the thought.
Okay. But doesn't, if the body does something bad, won't the Sakshi judge the body?
Sakshi never judges. Sakshi is witness. Like sun, sunlight is there, no? Sunlight, yeah. In sunlight, some animals will fight, some animals will kill each other, some animals will live happily. Does sun intervene?
No.
Sun just gives the light, right? Like that Sakshi just gives the light.
Yeah.
Light of the self, awareness.
Okay.
Right?
Prabhuji, you had told like the moon is the mind, then what is the earth? What is it? Is it the Atman or... What?
Earth is the body. Our body is made up of earth, no? Correct? Say for example, what food do you eat? Let's say you eat apple, no?
Yeah.
What is apple made up of?
It is made up of the seed of apple. When we grow, we get it.
The seed of apple grows in mud, correct?
Yeah.
It takes the mud. It takes the sunlight.
Yeah.
Now what is apple? Really mud in a different shape. So when you eat the apple, your body also grows. So now what are you really eating?
I'm eating the surface of the earth.
You are eating mud in the form of apple.
Okay.
So your body is also made up of mud only.
Yeah.
It looks nice, but it's really mud only.
Mud in the surface, it's the landform of the earth. So even we are eating the earth. Like, meaning we are eating the earth, you mean by?
We are eating earth, our body is made up of earth.
Oh, okay, got it.
Right, that's why people when they die, they will bury the body, right? Because it earth, what is made up of earth has to go back to earth.
Okay.
Are you clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Prabhuji, doesn't Sakshi get angry?
Sakshi never gets angry. Sun never gets angry. Anger is in the mind. Hello? So, Namit? Internet problem. Okay. So, anybody else has questions? Only child seems to be having more questions than the adults. So, you have to become like child.
Pranam.
Sheetal.
Yes, yes, Gurudev. Gurudev, you had said that you will let me know how to perform all activities as meditation.
Yeah, I'll teach you today.
Okay. And Gurudev, one more thing. This Asti Bhati Priyam Ramarupa, this thing, is an essence of the world.
Asti Bhati Priyam Namupa is the world, yes.
Is the world.
Right.
And Asti is myself, that is existence.
Right.
And Bhati is the awareness, the light of awareness.
Yes.
Priyam is the world is desirable,
yeah.
Because happiness is my nature, but the world cannot give me permanent happiness. Therefore, I seek self-realization.
World cannot give temporary happiness. World cannot give you temporary happiness. Permanent, forget permanent. World cannot give any happiness. World is there to make you unhappy. Okay.
Then, Naam Roop is the form and...
name and form.
Form. Name and form. This is all the world consists of.
Correct.
And this is what we have to know. And Bhati is Pratipati is the light of the self and the reflection of the light of the self.
Correct.
That's it.
So, what you see as the world is nothing but your reflection only. But if you focus on the object, we are in illusion. If you understand it's a reflection, I am back to yourself.
Yes, Gurudeva, one more thing. It seems like, you know, when we deeply contemplate, or, you know, even for that matter, nowadays when we sit back and have a look back at the conversations or something we have with others, it seems like, you know, continuously... in a sentence, one judgment will be there. How to get out of judgment, Gurudeva, please?
Who is judging? You have to find out. Does Sakshi judge?
Yeah, of course, Naam Roopa.
Does Sakshi judge?
No.
So, who are you?
I'm Sakshi.
Namit. Internet gathered. You are the Sakshi, right?
Yeah.
So... this is because of the habit pattern of identifying with the mind which is making judgment happen.
Yes,
slowly, slowly you have to come out of the habit pattern.
Yeah. Yes, Gurudeva. Yes, Gurudeva.
Namit, are you there? Namit? Hello?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yes. You wanted to ask a question, no?
Yeah, I forgot. When it comes to my mind, I'll ask.
Okay. Fine. Anybody else has a question? Okay.
Hello?
So, yes, Rajini.
Namaste, Guruji.
Yes.
Guruji, this moha and prema, how to get it? Moha is connected to BMI, no, Guruji?
Correct.
And prema is samarpana bhava.
Prema is atma.
How to get detached?
Who are
by
you?
Being attached?
Who are you?
Pardon, Guruji?
Who are you? Who is asking the question?
Again, the body, mind and intellect.
Who are you?
I am actually the Sakshi.
But
living in this world.
Living in this world, you have to...
Attachment and detachment is
see,
very difficult.
If you live in the world as Sakshi, detachment is very easy.
With respect to relations... It's very difficult.
No, not at all. It is becoming difficult because you are thinking you are a body and mind.
While doing karma itself, we should have that detachment, you mean?
Every time you have to remember, I am Sakshi and work. Then gradually that identity of the body and mind goes. Then detachment becomes very natural. Moha will become prema only.
Line we have to cross, Namruji, that is
who has to cross?
I mean, the Sakshi has to cross.
Sakshi doesn't have to cross. Sakshi is already fine.
I know.
Okay, what you are doing is you are identifying with the mind. That's the problem. Correct? So now, if I tell you that you should not be detached, you will try with the mind. The solution is not in the mind. Solution is to recognize I am Sakshi and live as Sakshi all the time. So then detachment will be natural and moha will, prema will be natural. That's why...
Maybe the situation, first it will come to body, mind and intellect only, Guruji.
Correct.
Our Sakshi will never raise it.
That's why Shravana Manana Nididhyasa has to be a continuous activity. We should not do, we should keep on doing it until we are fully established in Sakshi.
I know.
Otherwise what will happen? We'll fall back. Correct? So you know how many years I've been doing this sadhana? Almost 45 years. Not a single day goes without doing sadhana.
But while doing sadhana, our mind says, yes, you whatever is, Sakshi keeps appearing. When we get into this world again, the Sakshi disappears.
No, that is not a problem. That is actually a learning. So you have to improve.
I know, Guruji. Yes.
Right?
Yes, Guruji. Thank you, Guruji.
Okay,
thank you.
Welcome. So now who asked a question that, anybody else a question? Yes,
Guruji. Gurudeva, just now you said that every time there is a judgment, every time there is a identification with mind and body, go back, ask who you were, and you are the Sakshi, and you will be quiet.
Right.
This is the sadhana. And when you were saying in your natural state video number 2, it said that I is an imposter. The I is a small I here.
Yes, small I is the imposter.
Yeah.
Right? Big guy doesn't even open his mouth, no?
Correct. Yes.
One who opens the mouth is not real I.
Yeah.
Who is asking the question now?
Yeah, Nama Rupa.
The Sakshi has no problem actually. Sakshi is watching the fun.
Actually, really, it's just watching the fun. It's saying that, okay, let her ask whatever she wants.
Yeah. So, this is the problem. That's why God is always watching, just like this. Okay? So, He allows you to do anything. Walk, fall, everything. He'll give all the support, but He doesn't do anything. Okay.
Guruji.
Ah, yes, Saravan.
Yeah, Saravan. I keep hearing this and when I am reading or like contemplating about this, like I try to tell myself that remain in that Sakshi state.
Mm-hmm.
But if you see sun being in that state, it's almost like it's there, but like it's not there, kind of like
right.
Nobody thinks about it.
Right.
Right. But when we are involved in the society, right.
Mm.
Things are happening around us.
Yes.
And trying to be in a state like where I'm completely unreactive like a sun is like you don't exist.
No, you exist. You are very active, very conscious, but you don't react.
So when you don't react, you it looks like you don't exist.
No, you don't react, but you act. A conscious action is not reaction. A conscious action is not a reaction. Reaction is a programmed action. You act consciously.
Yeah. Maybe due to past conditioning, the body and mind always is like in a reactive
state. I'll ask Saravanan. Saravanan, are you married?
Yes.
So when you are interacting with your boss, you forget that you are married, or married is a background?
Yes, we forget. Yeah.
You will forget, is it?
Yeah. No, the sense
is in the
that is not there.
It's in the background,
that,
right?
That, yeah,
so boss will say, come at 7 o'clock in the night, evening, to the office. Then what he'll say? Immediately first thing is, I should ask my wife. Alright? So you will go back to your wife. So your wife is always in the background. Correct?
Correct.
And any action you'll ask your wife, without asking your wife, do you do anything, any activity in life?
Definitely. Yes.
Like that. Wife has to be replaced with Sakshi. Sakshi has become your wife. Your wife has become Sakshi. Sakshi has to become your wife. That's all.
But it's like, only if I'm conscious, I can even.
Are you unconscious of your wife?
Yeah.
Are you unconscious of your wife?
Yeah.
Huh?
I guess.
So you don't have to be more conscious. You have to just as conscious about Sakshi as your wife. That's all sufficient. Nothing else. Your life is changed.
But Sakshi remains quiet. Right? It doesn't put any kind of
Sakshi doesn't. Sakshi remains quiet. In that quietness, the clarity will come.
Actually,
said, in reality, your wife is also quiet. When she is quiet, you will act properly. So when she is angry, you just look at you. Then immediately you know what to do in life. Women have a very good technology. When she is angry, she will not speak. When she doesn't speak, you will understand what is to be done. Sakshi is like that only. Without speaking, it will get done. All the work done.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
He's but telling that's right.
I'm still not there in the sense. Yeah. Only after I react, I realize that I reacted and
trying to tell myself. Very simple answer for you, sir. Whenever you remember your wife, you remember Sakshi. That's sufficient. You will be free.
Okay.
Yes, Pratibha, you are telling something?
He said you are right that about being Sakshi and wife. I was like, what is this going on?
What is this going on? I am telling
you. Guruji, you always replace everything.
I'm telling you what is happening in your life. Okay. So, anybody else has question? Yes, Rajini, you have to unmute.
Okay, sorry. Guruji, thought which comes up, you said that is also consciousness.
Correct.
And it falls into the consciousness.
Yes.
So, as the water, it rises from the ocean and it falls.
Correct.
So, the wave is also water and the water is water.
Right.
But if you look at the wave, the nature of the wave is the same as the nature of the water.
Correct.
Thought is not the nature of the consciousness. Thought can be negative, thought can be positive.
No, the nature of wave is different. Nature of wave can be very big and destroy your buildings. Wave can be very violent. Right? The form has activity. The water has no activity. The moment you take form, it will act. The wave, you have seen the building, big waves coming and destroying the cities, right?
True.
So the water itself is serene. Yes?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes, Satyavati.
So what we do is, we just watch the thought and it will dissolve.
You don't give energy to thought. But you give energy to right thoughts. See, don't give energy to wrong thoughts or thoughts which will destroy you. Right thoughts, satsang, bhajan, prayers, service, all those thoughts you give energy. Right?
Right, good.
Yes, Satyavati? Yes, go ahead. Unmute. Satyavati, unmute. Satyaji, can you hear me? Yeah, Satyaji wants to ask some question. It's yes, Namit, you disappeared.
Yes, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, if why does consciousness create thoughts? Because it's a headache for it, no?
No. Consciousness has no headache. Consciousness has no headache.
Okay.
Sun has a headache if there's a tree.
Okay, because consciousness is infinite.
It just gives energy, that's all. It blesses everybody. So the tiger eats a deer. Is sun has a problem?
No. Only sometimes sadness may come.
No, sun doesn't get sadness also. Sun just gives light to the deer and the tiger.
Yeah.
The consciousness gives, blesses everybody.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Satyavati, you wanted to ask something?
Gurudeva, can I ask something?
Who is that?
Sheetal here, Gurudeva.
1 minute, Sheetal.
Satyavati wants to speak. Yeah.
Satyavati, come. Satyavati, finish.
Guruji, sorry, power went off.
No problem.
In that previous question, she asked about the wave and thought. You said the nature is same, but wave is the same, whereas thought, positive, negative. What I understand from your teachings is that when we look at the thought as from the ego point, it is positive, negative, everything. But when we go to the essence, when we go to the root, like from where it is coming, the essence is the same.
Correct.
Similarly, respect to what wave and water, essence is the same. As you said, wave takes a bigger form, it can destroy, everything happens. Same way, thought can be positive, negative. But when we come to the essence, it is the same.
Correct.
So, this understanding is right.
That's correct. Perfect.
When
it takes the form, so unlike a wave, the thought is consciousness only. That's a knowingness. So because of that, it thinks I am somebody and starts destroying somebody. It feels limited. Okay.
So the point here is the essence is the same for everything.
Essence
the
is same.
But we look at it like from the ego point of view, or consider it as this is positive.
Correct.
The wave is big, the wave is small. So essence is the same.
Correct. So it is like this: a farmer gets a stone, finds a stone. So he sees a very nice stone, and he sells the stone to a person who is going nearby for 10 rupees. That person takes the stone and goes home and gives it to wife, and uses it as a paperweight. So then if one day she sees that paperweight and sees this is nice, she will check with a diamond businessman. So is the stone you like it? He gives 100 rupees. Then he cuts it and polishes it and he sells it 1,000,000 rupees. It is the same stone, but the way you look at it makes a difference. Same consciousness, if you look at it as a thought, as a body, as a world, it will be different reaction in you. So we should become... You should look at the world from the consciousness point of view. Correct? Sir Rajini, you wanted something? No. Audio. Unmute.
Yeah. Thought, as Satyavati ji said, if it is taken as an essence, it is the same.
Correct.
But if I take it as a name and form, it can be destructive, it can be constructive.
Correct.
So let it dissolve. And I go to the constructive thoughts.
So, you don't react and you use dharmic thoughts, constructive thoughts and thoughts of service, thoughts of love and peace that you allow.
True.
Right? Don't react. So, anybody else has a question? Then I'll show you one video, then we'll discuss. Okay? I'll share something, you watch. First tell me whether you are able to hear the sound and all. Are you able to see this?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes, Prabhuji, here.
You are able to hear the sound also?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Prabhuji, is there a sound, Prabhuji? I don't think there is any sound.
There is a gentle sound, air breeze.
Okay.
Nothing, no audio, just breeze of air.
Okay.
But you can hear the phat phat sound when she makes that sound. Okay. Did you see the video?
Yes, Guruji.
Ah, so now, tell me, what did you see? What did you understand?
That he is doing the things fully.
Okay. So, can you tell, can anybody tell what is doing Sheetal? Sheetal, what she is doing?
The conviction, Guruji.
What is the conviction? What is the conviction?
Gurudeva. While preparing the tea, nothing else is there. Only that particular action.
Only that. Okay, very good. Anybody else?
Gurudeva.
Awareness. We should be aware on what we are doing.
Very good. Very good.
Sapna? Gurudeva. Yes, Sheetal. I saw that she was performing all her activities very mindfully.
Very mindfully.
Very mindfully.
Very good.
Yeah.
Sheetal? Not Sheetal. Sapna? Okay.
And one act was going on one by one slowly.
Okay. Vaishnavi?
Yes, it is slowly she is doing. It is very sacred in Japan, tea ceremony.
Okay.
I attended that.
Okay. Do we do puja as sacred? When we do puja, which is sacred, do we do it with that much of respect?
Yes. It is equal to our homa.
No, no. Do you do that? When you do puja, our mind is where?
Yes, yes. We won't do like that.
Okay.
It is very sacred.
So when you do mantra, Vishwam Vishnur Vashatkaro, coffee is ready. Paper has come or not? Bhuta Bhavya Bhavat Prabhu. Hey, don't do like that.
Yes,
so, Sheetal, do you understand the secret of doing work?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, Guruji.
So Sheetal asked the question, how do I do everything as karma yoga? This is how it is.
Gurudeva, actually one thing is, as you said, I had asked this question, then you had said, I will let you know. By looking at it, it is not like this mindful living. As you said, every time, you know, there is an interference from outside, then what do I do? For example, there is nobody there for her right now.
No.
I don't see any other
person. See, this is a practice. Okay? The soldiers, before they go to, can they practice shooting gun in the war field?
No.
Where do they have to practice? When the enemy is not there.
Bunkers.
When the enemy is not there.
Yes.
So you have to practice this whenever you get a free time.
Whenever I get a free time.
Whenever you are not affected by anybody else, when you are doing cooking, nobody will come there.
Uh-huh.
When you are sitting at home, nobody is there. That time you have to practice. You have to practice offline. Then online it will be easy.
Okay, you mean to say that whenever there is a function or a puja, for example, and I'm preparing Naivedyam, then do it, I mean, if there are, you know, 4 or 5 people around while doing Naivedyam, I should perform everyday cooking as if I am doing Naivedyam and be mindful.
Everyday cooking you should do properly, like a mindful way. So, have you heard of this Yuddha Kale Shastrabhyasa? Have you heard? Anybody has heard called Yuddha Kale Shastrabhyasa? What does it mean?
I think it's related to war.
Yeah, what does it mean?
It is, no, only when this one is there, you are practicing for that particular purpose, then the moment arrives.
Then you will get killed. If you want to practice shooting gun when your enemy is there, then you will get killed.
Yes.
You have to practice every day. Then you can fight with you. You can. So, spirituality is to be practiced all the time. Then when real life situation comes, you will be facing it.
Yes, Gurudeva.
This music concert is there, right? There are great musicians who give music concert, right? So 1 hour concert, how many? 1 hour. 10,000 people will gather. But for 1 hour concert, how many hours practice they do? They do 10,000 hours practice for 1 hour performance. Spirituality is our full-time activity. For 1 hour performance with your, 1 hour meeting with somebody, 1 hour this thing, you should have 24 hours practice. God is 24 hours.
Yes, Guru.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, Gurudeva.
Sheetal, are you married?
Yes, Gurudeva.
Are you full-time wife or part-time wife? Huh?
Yeah.
Are you full-time wife or part-time wife?
Full-time only.
Do you have children?
Yeah, I have a son.
So are you full-time mother or part-time mother?
Full-time. Full-time
mother. So only spiritual seeking only you can be part-time, is it? God only can be part-time, is it? Do you understand?
I'm a full-time devotee. I'm a full-time spiritual.
Part-time you can be mother, part-time you can be wife.
Okay.
Right? Then only life will be. The God is very demanding. Husband also is not demanding. Child is also not demanding. God is very demanding. Yat Kuroshi, Yat Joshi, Yat Dashnashi, Tat Kurushu, Mother Pandu. Krishna says in Bhagavad-gita, you know that?
No.
I'll chant this sloka, okay? You can repeat after me. I'll say, you can repeat, okay? Yat karoshi, yadashnasi, yad juhoshi, dadasi yat, yat tapasyasi kaunteya, tat kurushyo madarpanam. Yat karoshi, whatever you do, yadashnasi, whatever you smell, yad juhoshi, whatever you eat, the yad dadasi, whatever you donate, yat tapasyasi, whatever practice you do, Tatkurusha Madarpanam, you offer it to me, Shri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. Did you hear that? So, the God is very demanding. Whatever you do, you see, you blink, okay? You think, you walk, you talk, you have to offer to God. Husband is not demanding that much. Child is not demanding that much. God requires 100% attention.
In your video, in natural state video, I think Gurudeva, in the first natural state video, you have said that everything is an ahuti to the awareness.
Correct.
Does it mean this?
Yes, it means that. So, everything you have to live in awareness. So, that's why spirituality is not at all a part-time activity. Actually, what you think, no, spirituality, what people do, okay, there's a movie. During interval time, they come out. So spirituality has become an interval activity for the people. Spirituality has become a movie. Interval is your household activity. We have to start living consciously in full awareness. It doesn't mean that you have to run away from your work. Whatever work is there, you have to convert into worship. Whatever you do, you have to convert into offering. How do you do that is the question. Okay? Now I will come back to the tea ceremony. Okay? So, can you all of you raise your hand? Okay? Very fast, rapidly. Okay? So now, do it slowly. Do it slowly and becoming aware. Do it slowly, becoming aware of every muscle in the hand, body. So, what is the difference?
Did the work with awareness and without awareness.
When you do something rapidly, you are losing awareness. Your focus is on the result. When you do it with awareness, the focus is on the body, focus is on what's happening within the body, you become more conscious, you'll start living consciously. Right? How much of time will we do unconsciously, live unconsciously, tell me? All the time.
Most of the time.
Ah. So
all
if you,
the time, Guruji.
All the time. If you start living consciously, you're going closer to God. If you're living unconsciously, you're going to go closer to Prakriti, nature. So you want God or nature?
God.
But then God cannot be a part-time attitude, you know.
No.
If you become a part-time wife or part-time husband, you'll be kicked out of the house. Don't you think this Sakshi will kick you out if you're part-time Sakshi? Part-time Sakshi. Spirituality or spiritual living is a full-time commitment. It's not a part-time commitment. It's not a, oh, how many, 20 minutes daily, meditate for 20 minutes is sufficient? I'll say initially yes, but that's not true. Your 24 hours has to become meditation.
Hello, Guruji?
Yes.
Guruji?
Yes, yes.
Nature is also part of God only, no, Guruji?
Correct.
When we are with nature, we are slowly proceeding towards God. That's the meaning, no, Guruji?
When you are with nature, you have to understand nature. Nature is part of God, but nature is there to make you turn you towards God. Nature is not there to follow the nature.
Okay.
You understand?
Also,
no, listen carefully. First, listen carefully. Nature is part of God, but is there to make you turn towards God.
Okay.
Okay. So nature, everything in life will always have a pain and pleasure.
Yes, that's there.
Okay. Nature is not there to keep you comfortable at all.
Oh, okay.
Nature is there to make you as uncomfortable as possible. Till 6 months back, we were very happy planning for yatra. Okay, when I'll go to yatra, suddenly corona comes. Now no yatra, no jatra, home. Why? Corona is part of nature. It is there to make you uncomfortable. Okay, why make you uncomfortable? Then only you turn towards Atma. Nature is a part of God, there to make you uncomfortable. Are you able to understand? Everything in the nature is there to attract you, make you fall and make you learn and become uncomfortable so that you go back to Atma.
Okay,
good. So if you think that, oh, corona should come, I should be comfortable. Why corona has come? God has sent corona. God has sent corona as a part of nature to make you uncomfortable. The nature is not there to make you comfortable. But it doesn't make you so uncomfortable that your living becomes difficult. It will give you a little bit of comfort and make you uncomfortable.
Okay. Guruji, I have one more question.
No, is this question answered, first question?
Yes, I got it.
So tell me what you understood.
We say our body is made up of panchabhutas.
Correct.
That is our original this thing. So why the natural behavior of panchabhutas are not exhibited properly in our body, Guruji?
What is
that? It is impartial.
No.
All panchabhutas are impartial.
No, that's because you have identified it. No, do you allow the body to be natural? How many times you take a food every day? How many times you take food every day?
One tiffin and two meals.
Does your body require that? Are you allowing your body?
It has become a habit, Guruji.
Are you allowing your body to be natural?
That we have not tried.
No, your question is why panchabhuta body is not behaving naturally. Are you allowing your body to be natural? Tell me.
We are restricting.
That is the ego. Now, if you remove the ego, you'll be Sakshi, then body will behave naturally.
Oh, okay.
panchabhutas are yellowing, you're not yellowing. No, we are not yellowing anybody in natural. Everything we can unnatural. The problem is not in prakriti, problem is in human mind.
Okay.
Are you clear?
Yeah, Guruji.
So now, what is your question? Next question.
That's all, Guruji. So the mind is the culprit there. It's the mind that's interfering in our...
Ego is the culprit. Mind is the instrument.
Okay.
Ego. Me. I.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, Guruji. Thank you, Guruji.
Okay. Anybody else has a question? Yes. Satyavati?
Guruji. In that tea making ceremony, you have shown this before also.
Right.
And before also, your explanation was this only. There is no change in that.
Right.
But the understanding in the mind is becoming so clear.
Okay.
Every time I see it. That time also, you had said what you see, and that time the mind was taking it. Oh my God, she's taking so much time. But now, listening to your talk so many times, again and again, even watching this, everything is so clearly understood. And also, that when you say, like, I see a flower, there is an experience, there is duality, but in, during that experience, there is only one.
Correct.
So that oneness is there when she is doing it.
Correct.
I am able to at least get that now.
Correct.
I am also able to at least do it.
Very good.
In the day to day.
Very
so
good.
Keep telling, you have been telling. From that initial stage.
Very good.
But so much time is taking for the mind to implement it, though, like, you know, as you say, part time, full time, and all that. I'll get this much time, I'll do this. Then I enter the cooking. And when I'm doing cooking, something will be coming in the mind. But my need to get involved in that and to be in that, to, as he said, mindfully, that mindfulness, it is actually. Happening, sir.
Very good.
So
very good.
That oneness I can see when she's making the tea, and I'm able to connect now more clearly.
Very good.
Than what you have, I had seen before.
Very good.
So that tune is there, Guruji.
Very good. Correct.
Thank you.
Very good. Yes, Sheetal, you have a question?
Gurudeva, in the parable, that is Sagar Manthan parable. You said that, you know, a lot of things came out, like you said that healing came out in the form of Dhanvantri,
right.
And there were a lot of blessings like Kamadhenu and all.
Right.
And you told that there are siddhis, you know, which are attained on the way.
Right.
And you said that the Dhyani will not look at the siddhis, he will only look at the nectar, that is Atmajnana.
Correct.
I have seen that, I mean, they say that, you know, the miracles of, you know, enlightened gurus like Dutta Maharaj and all, they perform lot of miracles, that is, those are siddhis only, so they are still enlightened, they go back and use it for Loka Kalyana, isn't it, Gurudeva?
Okay, so I'll answer that question next. First, I'll answer first let us focus on the karma and then I'll answer the question. Okay.
Yes,
so, what did you understand and what changes you want to make in your life with this video?
With this video, I would see, you know, that my actions are performed in a way that is an arpanam to my awareness. That is always being in the Sakshi Bhav.
Correct. So, I will tell you one secret. Your Satyavati, you have to listen carefully. Okay. So.